Raking leaves into a pile can be such a chore, but there's a reward at the end. Jumping in! These leaf piles are fun, fluffy, and very colorful. But have you noticed that you only really get the chance to do this during one part of the year? Autumn! Every autumn, if you're lucky, you can see trees transform into reds, oranges, and yellows, as if Mother Nature herself got out her paintbrush. Do all trees change their colors? No. It turns out this magical transformation mostly happens in one special place, the temperate forest biome. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. So now we know that a temperate forest is a place with colorful leaves and that it's a biome. Biome? Biome? What exactly does that word even mean? Well, let's take it apart. Bio means life and ome means group. Put it all together and we get biome. A biome is a large region of the earth that shares similar climates, plants, and animals. A place where the wildlife is all grouped together because they have similar needs. Think of it as a natural neighborhood where specific types of living things thrive together. Now, the temperate forest biome is one of these neighborhoods. Found in parts of North America, Europe, and Asia, temperate forests are known for their moderate climate, not too hot, not too cold, with distinct seasons, including warm summers, cool winters, and spectacular autumns. It's the color-changing biome. How cool is that? You'll never get a chance to be bored in the temperate forest biome because something is always changing. If not the colors, then the weather. In temperate forests, you'll experience all four seasons: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. During the spring, temperatures start to warm up, and the forest comes alive with new plant growth and animal activity. As we move into summer, the weather becomes warmer with temperatures typically ranging from 60 degrees Fahrenheit to 80 degrees Fahrenheit, or 15 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius, and the forest is lush and green. Did we make it clear enough that we're most impressed with autumn in temperate forests? The temperatures begin to cool and the trees put on a dazzling display of red, orange, and yellow leaves. This happens because when conditions are right, like shorter days and longer nights, trees like oaks and maples stop producing chlorophyll. As the green pigment in leaves disappears and isn't replaced, the vibrant colors that were hidden underneath are revealed. Winter transforms the temperate forest. Temperatures can drop below freezing, often ranging from 20 degrees Fahrenheit to 50 degrees Fahrenheit, or negative 6 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius. Snow may blanket the forest floor, and many trees lose their leaves to conserve energy, giving the forest a quiet, serene look. Another reason it's so quiet in winter? Many birds migrate south for warmer weather, but they'll be back in the springtime, and some animals hibernate, which is sort of like a long, sleepy period where they stay in their den and don't go out to hunt or forage for food. But the trees aren't going anywhere. They stand guard silently through the long, cool winter. You can't have all those gorgeous trees without giving them a good drink of water. And this is something all the seasons have in common. Precipitation in temperate forests is fairly evenly distributed throughout the year. Annual rainfall adds up to an average of 30 to 60 inches, or 75 to 150 centimeters. This amount of rain is enough to support the growth of a wide variety of plant life, from big, colorful trees to small, delicate wildflowers hiding underneath. Our journey to uncover the secrets of every biome is just beginning, and we need your help. By donating, you'll help us fund our next video series all about animals living in each biome. Support our nonprofit and be a part of this wild adventure. Donate now, linked below. Did you know there are actually several different types of temperate forests? There are three main types: deciduous forests, coniferous forests, and mixed forests. Deciduous forests are famous for their broad-leaved trees like oaks, maples, and beeches, which shed their leaves every autumn. This shedding helps the trees conserve water and energy during the cold winter months. Then, in the spring, these trees burst into life with fresh green leaves. Next, we have coniferous forests. These forests are dominated by cone-bearing trees such as pines, spruces, and firs. Unlike deciduous trees, most conifers keep their needles all year round, which helps them survive in colder climates with heavy snowfall. The needles are adapted to retain moisture and reduce water loss, making these trees hardy and resilient. You can also find these trees in boreal forests, but many people don't realize that they can be found in temperate forest landscapes too. Speaking of boreal forests, be sure to check out our video on Socratica Kids all about the boreal forest biome, linked below. Finally, there are mixed forests, which combine elements of both deciduous and coniferous forests. In these forests, you can find a variety of trees growing together. This also means they can support a surprising mix of animal life, because every animal has their own preferred place to live and food to eat. We've been focusing on the trees in temperate forests because they're kind of the stars of the show. Big, majestic, but trees aren't the only plants you'll find in temperate forests. There are also plants who come together to form the understory. The understory is the group of plants and vegetation that live under the canopy of trees. I bet you didn't see that coming. Shrubs like azaleas and rhododendrons add greenery and color to the temperate forest. There are also ferns that live here and are known for their long, feathery fronds. And don't forget the wildflowers, such as trilliums and violets, that bloom in the spring, adding bursts of color and attracting pollinators like bees and butterflies. Seasonal changes have a big impact on plant life in temperate forests. In the spring, the forest comes alive with new growth. Trees grow fresh leaves, wildflowers bloom, and ferns unfurl their fronds. Summer is a time of lush greenery, with the forest canopy providing shade and the understory thriving in the warm weather. Autumn brings a dramatic transformation as deciduous trees prepare for winter. The green chlorophyll in the leaves breaks down, revealing vibrant reds, oranges, and yellows. Eventually, the leaves fall to the ground, creating a crunchy carpet that returns nutrients to the soil. In winter, the forest rests. Deciduous trees lose their leaves and the evergreens hold on to their needles, so there's still a touch of green even in the coldest months. Have you ever heard of flora and fauna? Ecologists like to use this phrase to describe what's living in a biome. Can you guess which is which? Well, we just learned about all the temperate forest flora, or plants. So now let's take a look at the temperate forest fauna, or animals. First, let's meet some of the mammals that live in the temperate forests. One of the most common residents is the white-tailed deer. These graceful animals are often seen grazing on plants and shrubs. Then we have the mighty black bear, which roams the forest in search of berries, insects, and sometimes fish. And let's not forget about the playful squirrels, always busy gathering nuts and seeds to store for the winter. Birds add a beautiful soundtrack to the forest with their songs and calls. Woodpeckers, like the striking red-headed woodpecker, tap away at tree trunks in search of insects. Songbirds like robins and warblers fill the air with their cheerful melodies, especially during the spring and summer months. But not all birds are noisy. Owls, such as the great horned owl, are masters of stealth, hunting small mammals at night with their keen eyesight and silent flight. Let's not forget the smaller residents of the temperate forest. Insects and other invertebrates play vital roles in the temperate forest ecosystem. Butterflies, like the monarch and the swallowtail, flit from flower to flower, pollinating plants as they go. Beetles, ants, worms, and spiders are busy decomposers, breaking down dead plants and animal matter and returning nutrients to the soil. These small creatures might be easy to overlook, but they are essential for a healthy forest. Next time you jump in a big pile of leaves, we hope you think about it a little bit differently. Maybe you'll think about how those leaves will eventually break down and return nutrients to the soil. Or perhaps you'll remember why these leaves are yellow and orange and no longer green. It's the lack of chlorophyll. But our adventure doesn't have to end here. Next time you visit a temperate forest, take a moment to look closely at the world around you. Notice the different types of trees, listen to the birds singing, and watch for the squirrels and deer going about their day. There's always something new to discover and learn. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.